Hi, I'm ARKS, A-R-K-S Srinivas. I am the national head for the MBA division of Career Launch. Since CAT is an aptitude exam, whether a student is from science, arts, humanities, or engineering for that matter, the basic preparation remains the same. However, a non-engineering student probably spends a lot more time on the quantitative ability area vis-a-vis an engineering student who puts a lot more effort in the verbal RC area. Other than that, I think preparing, going through the fundamentals, writing tests, writing mocks, analyzing them, I think it's very, very fundamental to any kind of preparation, and definitely for CAT too. As far as subject-wise preparation, I'll take it into three parts. Start with the quantitative ability area. This has four areas broadly: arithmetic, algebra, geometry mensuration, numbers. There is another area called miscellaneous, I can put it, but that will be the least of the concerns in that sense. So preparing one with the fundamentals of these areas, you know, going through the basics of arithmetic or basics of algebra, etc., will be the first stage of everybody's preparation. Second level would be to solve a lot of exercises which kinds of ensures that, you know, you also know the concept and the application of this. And the third level is writing tests. A concept, an application, and a test, I almost call it CAT, is the way in which you need to prepare for any subject for that matter. Quant, DILR will work beautifully for these two areas. But however, when it comes to verbal and RC, I think the conceptual knowledge itself is very, very high, and that requires vocabulary, grammar, reading speed, reading from various genres, various areas. I think what we recommend is take it a slightly longish period of time for preparation for the verbal side as compared to, let's say, a quant or DILR. So when it comes to a personal interview, we need to understand what the interviewer asks. Typically, a student is asked on various areas. A, he's asked on his personal background, personal history, what he has done, how he has done, etc. kind of things. More importantly, the personality questions like what are your strengths and weaknesses, what are your hobbies and interests, why do you want to do what you want to do, especially if you want to do an MBA, why do you want to do an MBA, what are your 5-year goals, 10-year goals, long-term goals. This is one area of preparation that one needs to do. The second area of preparation is either if you're already a working candidate, everything about your working experience, work as we call it, or if you are a final year graduation student, everything about the subject that you have been studying. So that 3 years or 4 years, depending on a degree, 3 years or a 4-year engineering, that comes as a very, very significant portion of your interview. And the third area, again, extremely important, is current affairs. Current affairs and general awareness, general knowledge. In fact, for this particular thing, reading newspapers on a long 5 months, 6 months level will be very, very useful. One important thing, especially given that CAT is supposedly a very difficult exam, people are very conservative in this exam. People think that if they attempt with the idea of accuracy in their mind, they may get more marks. But that's completely wrong when it comes to an exam, which is an aptitude exam like CAT. So one thing I advise them is, do not go into an exam with a mark in mind, with an accuracy idea in mind. Go into an exam thinking about how do I spend that 60 minutes or therefore 180 minutes for that CAT exam. What I mean by this is, plan your exam for 60 minutes. Do not plan for the number of questions you will solve or the percentage of accuracy that you are gunning for, because it's impossible to look at either accuracy or the number of attempts, because none of us know what is the level of difficulty that CAT is going to be this year.
Like the video? Subscribe to our YouTube channel and stay updated on other universities and entrance exams. Follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and www.careers360.com.